Okay, so I know it's difficult to find fun things to talk about with this Canadiens team. They dropped another game in overtime again to the Winnipeg Jets. And if you wanted to see my reaction live, hey, we did a stream for it, so you can go ahead and check the log. But today we're talking about some good news, because even though the team on the ice is struggling, there still are some really good things we can talk about this organization. And admittedly, a lot of it comes from the same guy, but it's a guy that everybody loves to hear about. Let's go over Cole Caufield, because he had himself another monster weekend in the NCAA for the Wisconsin Badgers, and we're nearing the end of the season here, the regular season in the NCAA year, and once we finish up what's going to be another weekend of games, we're going to have ourselves, I believe, the Frozen Four, or whatever it's called. We're also going to have the national championships and all that, so all the postseason stuff is going to happen after this next upcoming weekend, but the weekend that we just concluded was Cole Caufield's second to last in the regular season, and my gosh, did he and the Badgers make themselves an impact. This team just cannot stop winning games. We had ourselves what was a back-to-back against Ohio State, and this one was fun. The first game happened on Friday night, February 26th. That was a 2-1 overtime win for the Badgers, and it was really tight the entire way through. As you can kind of tell from the production here, a 1-1 tie heading into overtime. But this one started off hot, because it was Dylan Holloway, 4 minutes in, on the power play, who got a goal from Weisbach and Cole Caufield. From there, you had yourselves more shots and more power plays. The Badgers had 3 power plays in the first period. They only capitalized on that first one. Heading into the second, they were up 1-0 on the score sheet. The Ohio State Buckeyes also had a power play or two in this span in the first period and then in the second period that they did not capitalize on. But they had themselves their third power play of the night towards the end of the second period. They scored here, Gustav Westlund from Grant Gabriel and Quinn Preston, tying up the game with about 3 minutes to go. The Badgers then got another power play. They didn't convert. Then in the third period, the Badgers had another power play. They did not convert. And just looking at the penalty summary of this one, it was really rough what we saw over here. We had 10-minute misconducts, game misconducts, contact to the head, a whole bunch of minors, and all these rough penalties that went over. Lots of roughing going on as well. Lots of coincidental minors too. So we had a lot of penalties for these players over here. But then, in the third period, it was another power play with about 47 seconds left in the period. The Badgers didn't score in regulation, but in overtime, it's Dylan Holloway from Weisbach and Caufield once again. 2 very good goals from Holloway, assisted by Weisbach and Caufield. 2 power play goals, and what was a crazy exhilarating hockey game for the Wisconsin Badgers over here, putting themselves up 2-1 in overtime. However, even though we had 2 goals from Holloway, 2 assists from Caufield, and 2 assists from Weisbach, the story of this game mostly was the physicality, the roughing, and the anger that both of these teams projected onto each other. So for many watching the Badgers this year, they saw this game and they were like, wow, that was a feisty one. Would not be surprised if the tightness, if the conflict, I guess, carried over into tomorrow's game, because remember, all these games played between college teams, they happen back-to-back. They play 2 games apiece back-to-back, and so the Badgers had the Ohio State Buckeyes once again, and people were like, okay, let's see how this one goes. Well, spoiler alert, this one went a lot better for Wisconsin. A 7-0 shutout victory. And if you go over the box score and go over the highlights, go over what exactly went down in this game, Cole Caufield scored a hat trick. And it was very impressive. The first goal was Cole Caufield coming down in the rush. He tries a little bit of a toe drag on the defender. He tries the shot, but it's blocked by the guy who's in front of him. The puck bounces around, and Caufield backhands it baseball style on goal, right past the goalie to give the Badgers the 1-0 lead. Very impressive hand-eye coordination, very good clutch, in-tight kind of, you know, maneuvering over there going on with his stick. he just kind of chips it by the goalie who wasn't expecting a follow-through shot attempt. And that's just kind of the drive that Caufield has, man. The guy doesn't give up on plays. He's out there. Whenever he gets a chance, he'll try his best to get it on goal. The next goal for Caufield was the next goal for Wisconsin about 30 seconds into the second. It was Linus Weisbach, who else, coming in on the rush. He throws it cross-crease style, and Caufield, the right-handed shot on the left side, is right there for the one-timer. Beautiful plays, beautiful releases, and Caufield gets it done. From here, you had some more Wisconsin offense. You had Brock Caufield getting two straight assists on Dylan Holloway and Ty Emberson's goal. I saw a lot of Habs fans, especially in our chat yesterday for Montreal-Winnipeg, actually kind of confused about what happened in the game, because Cole Caufield finished off this game with a hat trick. He didn't get any assists. The assists were actually given to Brock Caufield, but because it reflects in the score sheet by saying that Caufield got assists, it made it seem like Cole had more points than he really did. But hey, a hat trick and zero assists, that's not something to complain about at all. So, Brock Caufield did his fair part of offense by getting some very good passing plays out there, setting up Holloway and setting up Emberson as well. But then you take a look at the next Cole Caufield goal. I was freaking out about the Nick Suzuki goal yesterday on stream because it was really similar to this goal that Caufield scored last night for the hat trick. The puck gets dumped into the offensive zone off the end boards, and it bounces over into the right side corner. Cole Caufield, as the right wing, is streaking in there to take it. He picks it up just outside the faceoff circle in between the goal line, and at a very tight angle, he throws it on goal. It's right by the goalie who's trying to hug the post. Caufield with an insane pinpoint accurate snipe shot that just squeaks by the Ohio State netminder. And that was really similar to the goal that Suzuki scored yesterday on Connor Hellebuck, the only goal that the Canadiens actually had in yesterday's Winnipeg Jets game, wherein they lost in overtime, so that certainly wasn't fun. But you know what? Caufield getting points is indeed fun. Take a look at the numbers over here. He has himself 22 goals and 42 points in 26 games played. Now, Odin Tufto, the guy who's been second in points the entire year, is right behind him with 40 points in 25 games. If we go over to Odin Tufto and take a look at what this guy's been doing over there with Quinnipiac University, he's been getting 2-, 3-, 4-point games like crazy against Colgate, Long Island, St. Lawrence, and if you take a look at the overall production that the second place guy Tufto has, even though he is a senior, he's out here with a very astonishing 11 points in his previous 4 games. So Caufield definitely has some good competition in the scoring race for the NCAA, but he is first in goals by quite a long shot. The second place guy, Colin Bielek, who is, of course, the guy that Leafs fans are using to troll Habs fans by voting for him for the Hobie Baker. He's got 16 goals on the year. Caufield is at 22. The goals per game actually is quite similar, as Bielek only has 19 games played, Caufield has 26. But of course, you know, the assists are up there too. Bielek has 6, Caufield has 20. And also the fact that Caufield is younger, which is something you should definitely take into consideration when thinking about how good these players are when they are scoring. Cole Caufield is the 5th Wisconsin Badgers freshman or sophomore to score 20 goals during the 2000s. The others are Danny Heatley, Joel Pavelski, Robbie Earl, and Luke Cunnan. Now, two of these guys are NHL legends. Danny Heatley, we know how good he was before, and I say before because he did fall off a little bit later. And Joe Pavelski is really good still. But if you go over to the actual game log, this is on Reddit. Take a look at the amount of games played it took for all these guys to get over to those goal numbers. Caufield did this in 26 games. That is by far the best goal per game number on this chart. Luke Cunnan is second, and he's only 23 years old, so we'll see how he is able to progress in his young NHL career. He's played a bit with Minnesota, a bit with Nashville this season, so we'll see how exactly that's going to go down. He was actually pretty good with Minnesota last year, but with Nashville this year, I mean, everybody on the Preds is kind of underperforming, so I don't really want to single out Cunnan over here. But that's a pretty good list to be a part of, especially Danny Heatley and especially Joe Pavelski. Really good stuff to see out of Cole Caufield, who is one of the top guys in Badgers history in the previous few decades to score a whole bunch of goals the way he has. So talk to me in the comments what you think about Cole Caufield. Let's use this as a way to kind of free ourselves up of all the bad stuff happening in Habsland, where they're losing games to teams that are above them in the standings, tightening the gap between them and the Canucks and the Flames and the Senators of all teams. I definitely don't think the Habs are that bad, but you know what? If they keep losing, we'll see where things end up in the next few weeks. Talk to me in the comments what you think. I hope you enjoyed this video. So, Ash Rolls 99. And bye.